This is August the 7th. Wayne is just giving a couple of wipe overs of Julian Stone's new 720 Bluefin that he's about to come and pick up, the new customer. And there's a few other bluefins here that we've got in the water as well on the dry stack. We turn this around, it's Pine Harbour dry stack in Auckland. We see there's another bluefin 720 over there with a Verado 200 on the back in the dry stack. And if we come back around again in the dry stack, you'll find another 720 bluefin inside over here in the covered dry stack. It's got a 200 Opti on it and your toilet and shower. And this one, Julian Stone's done some photos of his, and we'll go back to the recording again here as the truck comes over to zoom that out so we can see the truck coming over. Hey,
that looks like a boat.
Looks like a boat, doesn't it? I don't know whether you want it recorded, so I got it happening here, but this is Julian looking at his new boat.
Anything logo? Right.
Yeah, you'll like it once you see the little bits and pieces. Wayne, Julian.
Really nice colour, eh?
Oh, it's good, yeah, and it comes out quite good in the sun too. Quite nice having a little bit of it.
Get on YouTube just in case it catches.
Yeah. You've seen that one on YouTube, haven't you? That sort of plastic boat, and the boat fell off. That guy's diving off on his new boat, is it, you know? Good thing about this is if they did drop it and it wouldn't matter. It'd just bounce up and float. The only thing we haven't done is haven't put the fenders out. That's right. They don't seem to care that there's no bell ropes or anything there.
Yeah, what are they going to do?
Yeah. Thank you.
if you want to do it like him, you're going to have to put an anode on.
Yeah.
Okay, because...
we won't worry about that.
Because you've got so much stainless on the boat, i.e. your trim tabs and bits and pieces like that, yep. You've got conflicting metals, even though that I barrier coat them off with sealers, yep. So that there's a sealer pocket between them.
Yeah.
You've still got conflicting metals, so you'll need to...
Okay,
just the rubber.
That's it.
Yeah,
yeah.
Nice. I see the other ones, you had the little dog tag.
Yeah,
yeah, they
some,
rattle them.
Some people don't like these ones and they prefer. Sometimes you get a bit of a seaway. If somebody is leaning against it or something, it will suction.
That's the
thing.
Okay.
So
they're nice.
So you better undo your kit.
Yeah.
From down the bottom.
Is there a I better be careful what I say, Julie. There's someone
sneaking
down here. Check
out that. Now that's boat cushion.
This is like the weekend in Love Shack.
Those you can use as a round. There's Velcros on each of them. So if you just take it and roll it.
Okay, just leave that.
I see, I was looking for the rod racks, but I just see where you put them. Excellent.
So that's your security curtain just out of the way.
Yeah. Well, I tell you what, they took
these taps, you've got pickups on both on the underside of the hull. When you're not using the toilet, these must always be turned off. Because as you're going along, these will naturally, water will naturally vent up through the pipes.
Yep.
So what you might have is an overflow. So you always keep these tapped off. When you want to use it, it's just new. So that's water inlet.
Yep.
And that's excrement out there.
Yep.
Whatever. Okay, so you just turn those in line. And this will just...
Right here is from right under the hull, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah.
So right is basically right there.
Yeah, there's a scupper that's welded into the hull. So water flowing back won't, do you know what I mean? But once you start getting into a seaway, it can get shoved up there. So make sure that the...
So when we're out boating for a day...
And both those are off. Do your business.
Yep.
But bear in mind, it is wet. So dive tanks or anything along those lines, all the ones above here are all dry.
So that can be the flippers and whatnot.
Yep.
Yep.
So what idea?
That's the electrics, is it?
So when you say it's wet, not meaning it's draining from here, meaning it's going to drain in from the back.
Yeah, so like you come out from a dive, you put your tanks in here, you wet suits anything along those lines.
Yeah, I'll measure the size so and we'll get a container with a 10 centimeter lip to put things in.
So this would be where you'll keep all your cooking stuff.
Yeah, this is.
It gets a nice little.
And then
onto this. It's quite interesting because everything's a little bit different from
here. And have my eggs, I'm happy.
This boat is designed for two blokes to go catch, eat, live, predator. So
that's wood.
Yeah.
And just sits on those plugs.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's quite happy to sit on that without damaging the cooking plate or
the
glass. Okay, those will just stone back on again.
Yep.
Now then, so that swabs.
Velcro,
that swabs. Same on this side here.
That's good too. Okay, and this.
Yeah, you've got grab oils all the way through.
Yeah.
So, these are all.